This video presents information on providing brief tobacco cessation interventions. The goal of this module is to illustrate how cessation counseling and providing practical advice on effective strategies that increase a patient's odds of success can help patients understand the risks of tobacco use and the benefits of quitting. Busy practicing physicians may not have time for lengthy counseling sessions on tobacco cessation. However, brief cessation advice, as short as 3 minutes, has been proven to be effective in increasing tobacco cessation. There are several structured approaches that have been widely used for brief cessation interventions. One of the best known is the 5 A's model. The A's stand for ask, advise, assess, assist, and arrange. When using these strategies, it is important to ensure that the patient has easy access to all of the 5 A's. Let's look at each A one by one. The first A, ask. It is important to routinely ask all patients if they use tobacco. This should be done in a friendly and approachable manner. For example, may I ask if you use any tobacco products? Identify and document tobacco use status for every patient at every visit. The second A, advise. If the patient indicates that they use tobacco, advise them to quit. You can relay information on the harms of tobacco use and the benefits of quitting that have been described in previous modules. Your advice should be clear, strong, and personalized to the individual patient. This includes using appropriate language that can be understood by the patient. For example, it is important that you quit tobacco use now, and I can help you. And quitting tobacco is the most important thing you can do to protect your health. You can personalize these messages by saying something like, continuing to smoke makes your asthma worse, and quitting may dramatically improve your health. The third A, assess. This step will determine whether a tobacco user is ready to quit. For example, are you willing to quit? You may encounter patients at different stages in the change process. For patients who have not had thoughts about quitting and are not interested in cessation, you can use this time to raise their awareness about the health effects of their tobacco use. It is important to let them know that you are happy to help if they do become interested in quitting. For individuals who have had thoughts about quitting, but are not yet ready to set a quit date, you can use this time to emphasize the benefits of quitting. You can offer them the opportunity to answer any questions they may have to reduce their uncertainty, so they will be able to set a quit date in the future. The fourth A, assist. For individuals who are willing to make a quit attempt, your role is to help them do so. This could include putting together a quit plan with them. This plan will involve helping them to set a quit date, asking them to tell family, friends, and coworkers about their quit date to gain support, talking through any challenges they anticipate, and asking them to remove all tobacco products from their home and workplace. You can also prescribe any appropriate medication and refer them to a cessation specialist who has the skills and time to help them quit. And finally, the fifth A, arrange. Follow up regularly with patients who are trying to quit to offer further assistance. When assessing tobacco users' readiness to quit, some may be unwilling to stop using tobacco for a variety of reasons, such as misinformation, concerns about the physical effects of quitting, and prior unsuccessful attempts. Based on your assessment, when a tobacco user appears unwilling to make a quit attempt, a brief motivational intervention can be used called the 5 R's. The R's stand for relevance, risks, rewards, roadblocks, and repetition. Let's look at each R individually. The first R, relevance. Ask the patient, how is quitting relevant to you? If the patient does not think it is relevant, you may try explaining how quitting can improve his or her own health and the health of their family. The second R, Risk. Ask, what do you know about the risks of tobacco use that impact you personally? If the patient does not know, provide information on the harms of tobacco use as covered in previous modules. The third R, rewards. Ask, what would be the benefits of quitting that affect you personally? If the patient does not know, provide information on the benefits of quitting as covered in the previous modules. The fourth R, roadblocks. Ask, what would be difficult about quitting for you? Provide concrete steps to address these concerns. You can also tell the patient that it may take multiple quit attempts before he or she successfully quits. And finally, the fifth R, repetition. Repeat assessment of readiness to quit at each patient visit. The more often a healthcare provider brings up the subject, the more likely the patient will attempt to quit. Research indicates that patients do not mind being asked about their tobacco use and expect their physician to encourage them to quit. In addition to the 5 A's and 5 R's, there are other brief tobacco interventions that may require even less time and may be useful in your clinical setting. You will notice that all of these interventions deliver the 5 A's, but some of them are delivered by other healthcare or public health organizations. All of the interventions in the clinical setting include the ask and advise steps from the 5 A's. Let's take a look. The first is ask, advise, refer, or AAR. In this intervention, the health provider can refer a tobacco user to a quit line, cessation specialist, or other resource for quit plan development and further cessation management. And finally, ask, brief advice, cessation support, or ABC. In this intervention, the health provider provides cessation support for those who desire to quit. This may be done by developing a quit plan or referring to a cessation specialist. In closing, the 5 A's are a standard and effective approach for brief tobacco intervention. The readiness of the patient to quit tobacco will affect the amount of time required for the intervention, but even a brief intervention of a few minutes can be effective for increased quit rates. Furthermore, if you are not able to counsel a patient fully due to limited time, it is important to refer patients to cessation specialists or other resources in your community. The next video ready to view will discuss your role in tobacco control outside of the exam room.